Okay, now in this video, we are going to consider about the product of sums for prime implicants. Okay, so we are going to use the tabulation method for product of sums. So here the symbol itself shows it's a product, and these are all the max terms. So now we have to group. All the other things are the same except the interpretation. So here, group zero, there is no group zero. So in group one, you write as such 0001, then 3 is having 2 ones and 5 is having 2 ones. So those two are grouped. Then 7 is having 3 ones, 13 is having 3 ones. Those two are grouped together, and 4 M50. Now, as usual, you compare this and you form this, you will arrive at this solution. Okay. So finally, you compare this and then this with this, and you get this answer. Now we'll see the prime implicant chart. Here we write all are checked. So only these are unchecked, and they are all redundant. This is a redundant, this is a redundant. So we can take this and this. So 1, 3, 5, 7 and 5, 7, 13, 15, you write and put a cross mark, the respective max term. You write the max term here and then you put a cross mark for these term currents. Now you check for single cross mark. Yeah, this is one, this is one. These two have two. So this is one and so on. And then check the particular row where a single mark is present. Now, if you take both, only two prime implicants are there, and both are essential because of it. Because here it is also marked as single column, and this is also the single column. Now you have to write the combination. So when you how to write 1, 3, 5, 7, here we have the respective variable combinations you have to take. Now, if you take here, it is A, B, C, D. Okay, that is the combination of this. So here what you have to do is, if it is 0, you have to take it as its original value. If it is 1, then you have to take its complement value. That is how we write a max term. So now here, you have to write A as such, and you have to use plus symbol because it is product of sum. You have to write it as sum. So it is A plus, here you should not write as D, this D bar you have to write. So D bar, and then put it in a bracket, multiplication, then this, here there is no A because A is eliminated, but we have B bar plus D bar. Okay, so write, put them in the brackets, so that these two terms will be multiplied. That is product of sums. These two are sums, and we are finding the product of these sums. Okay. Now you can draw the corner map for this, and then you can check your answer. Now we'll see the next example. With don't care. Okay. So here, when you see this, 0, 8, 10, these are all the max terms. And this is the don't care condition of this max term. So as usual, you arrange them according to the single ones, two ones, etc. And then finally, we check all these things and we find a matching pair of this. And we come to this solution. Here while doing, this is not matched, this is not matched, this is not matched. And here, these two are redundant group. Okay. So and this is the so we take these two values. Now you form the essential prime implicant table. So write down the max terms. There is no need to include the don't care conditions here. Now you write the combinations 8 and 12. So you mark it 8 and 12. Then 12, we have 12, 13. So mark it 12 and 13. And 13, 15, likewise. So find the one which has a single mark. So this one and this one. Now check that particular row 13, 15, and go here, take that combination. This is nothing but A bar, B bar plus D bar, the first term. Then this we have finished. Now we check the 0, A, D, 2, 10, this. So here how you can write, A is the here, B and D. So B plus D. So that is the answer. And here, this is one more term, which is unchecked. Because since it is not included, okay, 13 is taken care here, but 12 is not at all taken care. Even here also, it is not taken care. So we have to include this term in our final output. So you can write this combination A bar plus B bar plus C. So this is our final answer.